good, YouTube? You're back with the Prez. And today I'm going to be teaching you guys about the planes of motion. This is going to be a train smarter, not harder, but we're still going to be training hard. That's just the slogan. Train smarter, not harder, because remember, guys, we want to avoid injury. So a lot of this workout is going to be injury preventative as well. So I'm going to be teaching you guys about the planes of motion that the body goes through. Listen, all movement, whether it be general movement throughout your daily life or exercise, is going to take place in either one of the three planes of motion. So now we have the frontal plane, we have the sagittal plane, and we have a transverse plane. So let me give you a quick breakdown of each plane to give you guys a little better understanding. Let's start with the frontal plane of motion. Imagine your body is cut down from the top to the bottom, splitting you from front and back. So you have a front side of your body and a back side of your body now. You're split down the middle that way. Now imagine a big piece of glass is placed in between the front half and the back half. And now all you can do is move your limbs around this plane. Remember, you have a big piece of glass and you're split in half. So any movement that would be able to be done in a plane like this, something where you don't have to move forward or backwards or twisting, remember, you have a piece of glass here preventing you from moving. Anything that can be done in a plane of motion like that would be considered a frontal plane movement, whether it be in daily life or an exercise. Now we have the sagittal plane. Now again, we're going to split our body in half again from top to bottom. But instead of splitting it from front to back, we are now going to split our body from top to bottom, but we're going to split our body in half from a right side and a left side. So now imagine we have a big piece of glass splitting our body down the middle like this. So all we have is a right side and a left side. So now any movement that can be done in a plane of motion like this, remember we have a glass here, we can't twist, we can't move our arms up because we have a big piece of glass here. So what we can do, anything that's allowed to be done in this plane of motion where this glass is splitting our body in half this way will be considered a sagittal plane of motion exercise. And now let's go to the transverse plane, the third plane of motion. Now we're going to split our body in half from top to bottom. We're going to cut our body right across the waist. Now we're going to imagine again, that big piece of glass is now splitting our body in half like a coffee table. We have a top half and a bottom half. What can we do in this plane of motion? Anything where it's allowed a twisting or a rotational type exercise, that's going to be done in the transverse plane of motion. So again, guys, quick recap. We have the frontal plane, body is split down top to bottom, leaving you with a front half and a back half. We have the sagittal plane, splitting our body again from top to bottom, leaving you with a right side and a left side. And then we have the transverse plane, cutting our body from top to bottom, across the waistline in the transverse plane, allowing for that rotational movement across this axis. So those are three planes of motion. And now we'll be taking you to the gym. We're going to be doing a hybrid style, weights and calisthenics, best of both worlds, style of training, where we're going to be training opposite muscle groups as supersets. Opposite muscle groups are known as antagonist muscle groups. So we're going to be working the same plane of motion for opposite muscle groups. This is going to be a science-based workout. This is going to teach you guys a lot. Follow along, and I'll see you guys in the gym. Let's get it.
All right, so here we go, guys. Starting it off, so you're going to see I'm training with my boy Jamie today. You guys have seen him in previous videos. So this is just going to be a quick warm-up. I have sped up right here. So the routine is standing military press, right into a pull-up, right into a dip. This is warm-up. We're just doing the bar for 10 reps, 10 bodyweight pull-ups, 10 bodyweight dips. Now, guys, like I said, this is going to be working the same plane of motion, antagonist muscle groups. So right now, we're working in the frontal plane, doing these standing barbell military presses, supersetting them with pull-ups. Now, when we get into the dips, which is an antagonist muscle to the pulling muscles, but it's actually a synergist to the pushing muscles in the military press, but the dips are worked in the sagittal plane. So we have two frontal plane exercises, which is the standing barbell military press and the weighted pull-ups, and we have one sagittal plane exercise, which is the dips. And this is us still warming up. So after we did the bar and body weight reps, we threw 25 pounds on each side for 95 pounds on the standing military press. We did 8 reps there. Then we threw a quarter on the weight belt, did 8 weighted pulls, 8 bodyweight dips. And again, this is just the warm-up to get blood pumping into the working muscles, get us ready for the heavier sets to come. All right, so here we go, guys. This is my first working set. As you know, in my previous videos, I've been building back my shoulder strength. So I just threw 125 on the bar. And now this routine is going to be a strength-based and an endurance-based pyramid set. Everything is going to be supersetted. So we're going to go from the standing military press right into a weighted pull-up, then right into a weighted dip. But it's going to go like this. The standing military press is always just going to be one single rep. We're going to keep increasing the weight until we hit a max weight for singles, and we're going to work at that single for a few sets. After the single rep of the standing military press, we're going to go right into weighted pull-ups. The first set of weighted pull-ups are going to be our heaviest set, which is right now I have 70 pounds on. We're just doing one rep. When we get to the dips are always double the amount of reps than the pull-ups. So here we have 70 pounds on. Now we did one pull-up at 70 pounds. We have to do two dips at 70 pounds. So now you're going to see the second round we go, it's going to be another single rep in the standing military press, or we're going to decrease the weight in the weighted pull-ups and the weighted dips, and the reps are going to increase in those two exercises simultaneously. So this is Jamie's first set. He's a little stronger than me in this movement right now. So I start at 125 on the bar.
Light.
He's doing his first set, 135 on the bar. You see easy he moves money. That pretty smooth. He stays at the 70 pounds for the weighted pull, hits his one rep, and also hits his two dips with the 70 pounds easy. So just keep in mind, the main exercise that we're building strength on in this circuit is the military press. The weighted pulls and the dips are just accessory work to build up some strength and get some volume in the same planes of motion.
Easy. So we're doing, guys, two frontal plane exercises, one sagittal plane exercise. Guys, think about it, same planes of motion. Standing military press, weighted pull-ups. I'm gonna put you guys on, guys. Listen, follow along.
All right, here we go. Here's my second round. So as soon as Jamie finishes his dips, I go right back to the bar. He started his set with 135, I started at 125. This is my second round, I upped the weight to 135 again. Remember, we're building strength in these military presses, that's why we're only hitting single reps, working up to our single rep max. So right now for me, it's 135.
That's a new OCR. I got 135 again, happy for that.
And again, as soon as we're done with the military press, we go over to the weighted pulls, and remember, these are pyramid sets now. The pulls and the dips are gonna be decreasing the weight each set and increasing the reps. So the first set on the weighted pulls, we had 70 pounds for one rep. Now we dropped it to 60 pounds, and each set, the weighted pulls are gonna go up by one rep, and we will double the number of dips that we do pull-ups. So here, 60 pound weighted pull-ups for two reps, and we'll go right into a dip. Remember, the dip is the sagittal plane exercise of the circuit. The first two are frontal plane movements, so now 60 pound weighted dips, we hit four reps. So whatever we hit in the pull-ups, we double in the dips. And just because it's relatively lightweight, you'll see that I'm really slow in controlling these reps, trying to get a nice pause and nice squeeze on top. And here we go, here's Jamie's round two, and like I said, he's stronger than me in these presses, so he jumped his weight up to 145 on the military presses, and that's how you build strength, guys. Working in these single rep ranges, trying to push out max weight for one rep, as many rounds as you can. That's how you get stronger at a given weight. And here you're gonna see he's just wrapping up his pulls and dips for the second round. All right, let's get it, round three. So I'm dropping Jamie's weight back down to my weight, and I'm sticking at the 135. Like I just mentioned, this 135 is now a new PR. I used to do this for reps, but as of recent, I haven't been able to do it, so this is considered a new PR for me, so I wanna get really comfortable controlling this weight, and you can see, it's a struggle for me. I'm grinding out these reps. 135 for one rep, it's not coming easy. I'm really squeezing that bar, trying to push these reps out, and then again, back to the weighted pulls. Now we drop the weight again. We drop down from 60 to 50 pounds now. We're gonna be hitting three weighted pulls, six weighted dips. Now I want you guys to notice the weighted pulls, how I'm doing them. It's gonna look like I'm not bringing my chin over the bar, but what I'm doing is I'm slightly arching my back, retracting the scapula, really pulling down from my elbows and trying to get a nice contraction on the lats there. So 50 pounds for 3 reps on the weighted pulls. Now we got 50 pounds for weighted dips. And again, 6 reps now because we got to double the pulls. And again, nice slow controlled pause reps, getting a nice squeeze on top, really flexing the muscle each rep. And let's go. Here is the 4th working set. Again, we got 135 on the bar. That's pretty much where I feel my limit is right now. You can see I'm really grinding for these 1 reps at the 135.
Come on,
so listen, when you guys are grinding for a rep like this, I really recommend squeeze the bar. Squeeze the bar as tight as you can. It's going to help you force that rep out. And make sure you maintain the form. Keep your back tight, everything straight. You don't want to have that lower back arch, core tight, everything. Now, for the weighted pulls now, we dropped from 50 just down to 45. We're going to be doing 4 weighted pulls, 8 weighted dips. And we did 2 sets at this weight. I didn't show set 5 here, but we stayed set 5 again at 45 pounds for the weighted pulls and dips. We didn't want to drop any lower. So I hit one more set at 135 for military press after this, set 4. And then we did one more set 5, where we did the same thing. 4 weighted pulls, 8 weighted dips with the 45 pounds. And again, you'll see here, really controlling, pausing each dip rep, really trying to get a nice squeeze on the chest. So that's how you guys can manipulate weight. If you guys got added weight and it's still too light, slow the reps down, really try to squeeze, flex the chest each rep. All right, here we go. We got Jamie's top set. We got him working at 160. So he increased the weight each set. He started at 135, went to 145, 155, and then he maxed out at 160. He did 2 sets at this 160 also. This is set 4 for him as well. And again, he stayed at the 45 pounds for the weighted pulls and the weighted dips for both round 4 and round 5.
Guys, for stability exercises, we're gonna be working frontal plane movement and a sagittal plane movement together as a superset. So, reverse kettlebell presses.
I actually kind of misspoke here in the video. So, this type of military press, if you'll notice, my elbow is in front of my body as opposed to it being more flared out as if I was using a barbell military press. So, these presses are actually done in the sagittal plane due to the nature of the elbow. And you're gonna notice when I go to the dips, it's gonna be the same thing. So these are 2 sagittal plane exercises again, and these are gonna be synergist sets. So we're working a press in the kettlebell reverse grip presses, and then we're working a dip in the next exercise, which is also a pressing movement. So these are gonna be synergist sets in the same plane of motion. So we're working sagittal plane now, reverse grip kettlebell press, right into these ring dips, which you're gonna see next.
Right into dips. Listen, I don't got the rings for you today. Same thing as using the rings. So if you guys got rings, this is how you guys want to be doing your dips in this exercise. 10 reps, Jay.
So the combination of the reverse kettlebell presses with these ring dips are really going to work all the stabilizer muscles throughout the whole arm. Remember, guys, the rings are causing instability from the wrist up to the shoulder, and the kettlebell is causing it basically from the shoulder up to the wrist in reverse. So instability in both these exercises, both going to really work on strengthening the forearm, the wrist, the elbow, and the shoulder in general, just practicing these two movements alone. And just due to the nature of it just being hard, you guys don't need to use a lot of weight here. We're only using, starting with a 25-pound kettlebell. You'll see in the subsequent sets, I go up just slightly. So again, you do not need to use heavy weight here. You're really focusing on form and controlling the weight. And if you just read that last clip, you're going to notice, see how Jamie's now pressing more in the frontal plane of motion? His arm is now out to the side, flared out, and his elbow's not in front of him. So he's actually pressing this in more of the frontal plane as opposed to the sagittal plane, which I tried correcting him and telling him to put his hand more neutral in the sets to come. And you're going to see here, we got Big E training with us also today. So we got Big E working in the back. We got me and Jamie doing these sets.
Dips next, Jay.
How was that?
And you can see here, once Jamie moves to his left, he's having a real hard time pressing this weight up. He cannot control it. One, he's trying to rush it too fast. And two, he may just have a little less instability in the left hand. He's strong in pressing, he's strong with a barbell, but he doesn't do much instability training. And you can see it's showing right here. So if you're going to watch the next clip, I'm going to show you guys how we can work on this and how we can activate the nervous system to wake up the stabilizers to make this move a little more effective.
Come on, he's got a strong press. He doesn't have the stabilizer muscles. Come on, Jay. Focus on it. Come on. Squeeze the weight. Come down. He's gonna get it. Eat 10 on each side. Five again.
Now we got E here also working on military presses. We're going to have him working up to a single one rep max as well. And in between his sets, he's doing his frontal plane superset where he's going into right into a dead hang. Right on the pull-up bar, he goes right into a dead hang. And here he's got 115 on the bar, and he's repping it for an easy 6 reps.
Control that. Control it. There we go. Come on. Come on. You see how he's shaking? These are all the stabilizer muscles that he's not used to working. He's solid when it comes to lifting barbells. He doesn't do much stability work, so you see, it's a struggle for him. Different strengths. All right, that was set one of this. We got two more rounds of these presses.
So here I moved up to 30 pounds. The 25 pounds for me was relatively easy. I was able to control it, and I had to move up the weight so I could challenge myself, continuously strengthen the elbow joint and the wrist joint, shoulder joint, especially in this right arm, so that's why I had the elbow pain. So 30 pounds here, and I dropped the reps down to 8 reps each arm. What also gets worked with this reverse grip kettlebell press is your grip strength. You really have to focus on squeezing that kettlebell. You guys can see it's shaky, it's unstable above my head. And the way I control that is by squeezing the weight. I do not let the weight take control of my wrist. I really try to keep my wrist straight and neutral the whole time. The second you get a little bit of instability in the wrist, that kettlebell is gonna come over and you're gonna lose the set.
Dips.
Oh yeah, my bad.
I tried cutting his workout in half. Come on. Jamie, just go to that 90-degree hold. Hold that, hold that, hold that, hold that, hold that. Don't let the weight bend. Try to press up. Control it up. Control it up. Bring it down. Neutral. Neutral, there you go, hold that. Hold that, activate the nervous system, good. Activate the stabilizers, press. Keep it neutral, keep it neutral. Keep it, keep it, keep it, keep it. Okay, better, there we go. All right, E, hold on, let me get behind you.
And as you can see here, I'm also supersetting the training. So I'm going from Jamie to Biggie here. Here we got Biggie hitting his one rep max right there. He put on, I think he has on 125 also. And look at the progress you're gonna see now on his dead hangs. A few months ago, back in November, when we were doing the 300 rep challenge, when he was doing 100 seconds of dead hang, bro, he was only barely in the hang for like 10, 15 seconds, 20 seconds tops. Now look, he's getting his legs up, almost going into a full L.
Too easy, good shit.
Nothing but progress, and big ups to E for getting better and better every day.
Let's go, keep going, 6, let's go, 7, 8, come on E, 9,
and now we got Biggie doing his drop set for his last set to increase the volume. Also going to really increase the heart rate. Once you start throwing in more reps, trust me guys, the heart rate's dramatically going to increase. And that's what he needs. That heart rate sped up is going to help him stretch, shed that fat, and also get stronger over time. And straight from these presses again, back to his dead hang. Remember, these two frontal plane exercises that Biggie's working in also. And look here, guys. Look, he gets his knees up. He gets a nice, full, tucked L-sit hang. So, again, big ups to E. Killing it daily, there always making progress, always doing extra shit that I don't even ask him to do, so keep it up.
6, 7, 8, 9, good
one. And here's another progress clip for you. This is Biggie back in November doing the 300 rep challenges of him doing his dead hangs there. You can see he's comfortable on it, but he couldn't get his knees up, and he also looked like he's really struggling to hold his grip. He looks a lot more comfortable on the bar now.
15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. 2, 23.
All right, here, I really want you guys to watch how I'm doing these rows now. Many of you guys may not have saw rows done in this variation. This is an old school bodybuilding technique, and you will see many pro bodybuilders still training this way right now. So with these rows, we're on a cable now, and we're leaning forward instead of being upright. The reason why we're leaning forward is, if you guys could look at the line of the cable, look at the line of the lats. They're in the same line of pull. So the lats really get targeted deeply and really, really perfectly when you're leaning forward like that. It's a completely different stretch than when you're doing them upright. But we like to do upright rows too, so we're doing them as a superset. We're doing 10 reps leaning forward, 10 reps upright, and this is another sagittal plane exercise. And again, we're working antagonist muscle groups here. So we started with the rows for the back, and now we're gonna go into a standing upright cable chest press. Again, working the sagittal plane. So we're doing a pressing motion in the sagittal plane for the chest, and a rowing motion in the sagittal plane for the back. Two antagonist muscle groups working the same plane of motion back to back. And now you're gonna see, here we're going into more close grip rows. So we did two sets of the wide grip rows, leaning forward and upright, supersetted with those cable chest presses. And now we're going into two sets of leaning forward close grip rows. What these close grip rows are gonna allow you to activate is, they're gonna really hit the deep, the lower lats, especially when you lean forward. Again, look at the line of the cable, look at the line of the lats. They're pulling in the same line. You gotta think about that, guys. That's how you can really focus on gravity and getting a peak contraction and putting up muscles in their optimal lengthening position to get a good contraction. And again, straight from the leaning forward rows, we go more into upright rows again. And here we just hit 8 reps on the upright because it's part of a superset. And then straight from there, back to the cables, back to another sagittal chest motion. But instead of doing presses here, we're doing supersetting with this with wide grip, low cable flies. So the low cable flies are going to target the lower chest, same way that those close grip leaning forward rows are going to really target the low, deep lats. All right, so we're moving on to the last exercise of the day, working more in the synergist muscle groups now. So here we're gonna be doing dumbbell side lateral raises back in the frontal plane. And straight from there, we're gonna be going into another chest exercise. Remember, synergist muscles work together, chest shoulders, antagonist muscles work opposite, chest back, shoulders back. Remember, push, pull, opposite muscles, push, push, similar muscles being worked. So when you're doing chest, your shoulders are gonna be getting hit. When you're doing shoulders, upper chest will be getting hit. That's why they're synergist muscles. So straight from those dumbbell side lateral raises, we went now into what I'm gonna consider ring flies, even though these aren't rings. You can do these on a TRX or on ropes, whatever you got. Remember, the rings, again, are gonna cause another element of instability, and these flies are gonna really target my chest, get a nice stretch, nice contraction when I come up. So, three rounds of this superset, kept the light, weight pretty light for the lateral raises, 15 pounds, wanting to hit a nice 12 to 15 reps each set.
Let's go.
Now you're gonna see, this is Biggie's burnout routine.
Let's go.
So what he's doing here is a snatch, push-up, pyramid.
There we go.
He started with 14 kilos for his first set of snatches, hit 10 reps, right into two push-ups. Then he went up to 16 kilos on the snatches,
easy money,
four push-ups, 18 kilos on the snatches, six push-ups, 20 kilos on the snatches, eight push-ups. Then he stayed at 20 kilos again for another 10 push-ups. So the snatches went from 10 to 2, and the push-ups went from 2 to 10. Simultaneously, so it was five rounds.
Six right away.
Pyramid, snatch the push-ups again.
Come on.
First round was 10 snatches,
one,
two push-ups.
Two.
Second round,
three,
eight snatches,
four
push-ups. Third round, six snatches, six push-ups.
To your right.
Fourth round is four snatches, eight push-ups, and the fifth round is two snatches each hand with the heaviest weight and 10 push-ups to wrap it off. So, 30 reps of snatches total, 30 reps of pushes total.
Six.
Back to back to back to back to back for Biggie to burn out at the end of his workout.
Two. Let's go. Three. Four. Come on. Five. Easy money. Come on. Six. Let's go. Let's go. Perfect form right now, E. Come on. Let's go. Easy money. Let's go. One. Two. Three. Let's go. Four. Five. Clean reps, E. Take them all off.
And this is how I burned out for the routine. Again, guys, I'm working antagonist muscle groups here, trying to stay in the same plane of motion. So the first thing I did was go into a max time handstand hold. I caught about 25 seconds here. And straight from this hold, I'm going into a neutral grip pull-up. Isometric hold, chin over the bar. So keeping my body in that same line of motion, going into a neutral grip pull. This is gonna keep me, this handstand is gonna be more on the frontal plane. When I get into that neutral grip pull now, neutral grip because my arms are gonna be facing forward as opposed to my elbows flared out, it's gonna put me a little bit more into that sagittal plane. So frontal plane, handstand hold, right into an antagonist muscle group for the back, doing these neutral grip isometric pull-up holds. And I'm trying to max the time that I held in the handstand in these isometric pull holds. So I did three rounds of this to wrap up the routine for the day. And that was a wrap for the whole session, guys. Listen, this is how we train smarter. There's a lot of science behind training, guys. The most successful lifters and bodybuilders all understand the science in training. We go into each session with a purpose and we try our best to execute it. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget, like, comment, subscribe. Peace out. Bar Naturals.